Welcome, everyone. Thank you for coming. It's been a long pandemic, and I'm very happy to have an audience to play for. I wanted to say a few words about this instrument, the viola d'amore, the viola of love. This instrument has very ambiguous origins in Italy. I think there's probably Middle Eastern influence as well. One characteristic of this instrument you'll notice is it doesn't have F-holes. These are often described as sort of flaming scimitar holes. And you'll notice on this instrument as well, there's some strings that run underneath the instruments that I wrote. There are steel sympathetic strings that kind of vibrate sympathetically to the bowed strings. It sort of creates this sort of silvery sheen. Leopold Mozart described this instrument as being particularly charming in the stillness of the night. This instrument here, it has six bowed strings. It also comes in seven, but I think that's silly. So I just have the six one, it's a little simpler. There are actually several versions of this instrument. I think if you ever see a concert of this, you're gonna see this one, which is bowed gut strings, metal sympathetic strings. In the 17th century and surviving in Lutheran lands, you have this older version of the instrument where it's actually just bowed steel wires without the sympathetic strings. And this is actually the instrument that Bach is writing for when he writes for Viola d'Amore and the St. John Passions and cantatas and geometric music. But this instrument, it's good for Vivaldi and the Catholic lands. They use this one. So we're gonna start. Please enjoy. Thank you. One detail I forgot about this instrument is there's no standardized tuning. So it tends to be tuned in the key of the piece that it's in. Hence why there's not a huge variety in the keys on this program. They're all either D minor, D major. That first sonata, F major, kind of fits, so I was able to flow them.
Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm.